In 1948, wood was one of the principal materials used to stunning effect in an international design classic. And Drews brought one into his photographic studio.
This is the Noguchi coffee table.
Designed by the celebrated Japanese-American architect and sculptor, Isamu Noguchi, at its launch, the table was described as sculpture for use. It went on to become one of the most recognizable designs of the mid-20th century. When he started out, artist Isamu Noguchi was famed for his striking sculptures, but he later began taking on other design commissions. In 1939, he was introduced to British designer Terence Robs John Gibbings, who got Noguchi to design a modernist coffee table for him. Then the Japanese attacked Pearl Harbor. The American authorities sent anyone with Japanese heritage to an internment camp. Noguchi spent 6 months in one. During his time there, he was able to get hold of design magazines. And while leafing through one, he saw something he recognized.
What I have in front of me is a picture of an extremely rare coffee table by Terence Robs John Gibbons. Noguchi saw this picture in a magazine. He instantly knew that his design had been stolen, and he was absolutely furious.
Robs John Gibbons refused to give the sculptor any creative credit, but Noguchi would yet have his moment of glory. Before his internment, he'd created a similar three-legged table in rosewood and tempered glass for the president of the Museum of Modern Art. After Noguchi was freed, an influential American furniture manufacturer, Herman Miller, asked him to design a less expensive version for mass production. What Noguchi came up with consisted of just three components which could be separated for transportation. And so this clever design was a flat pack before its time.
Two pieces of wood that are exactly the same on a pivot with a piece of glass. That's it. Business-wise, the manufacturing is incredibly easy. And what I really like about it is the fact that you've got somebody who's coming at furniture design from a totally different angle.
The two legs meet each other at a 52-degree angle, considered the best for aesthetic appeal and stability, allowing the heavy plate glass to rest on top without being fixed to the base. The table went on sale in 1948. It's still in production today.
Usually with art, it's form over function, but with this, it gets both. I think that is why this has been so successful for such a long time. It's because it's a piece of art and a structural piece of furniture.
Today, the table by Terence Robs John Gibbons, based on the design by Noguchi, is on sale for around £7,000. And in 2014, Noguchi's original rosewood masterpiece sold for over £3.5 million. A vintage model of his Herman Miller flatpack version goes for a lot less, but they still don't come cheap.
If you want to buy one of these, try and find one of the originals sold by Herman Miller with a cherry wood base. Those ones can be for sale for around £8,000. But there's a couple of things you want to look out for. All of the basics, condition, is it chipped, cracked, scratched, all of those. One thing that is constant in this sort of furniture are cheap reproductions, copies. They never really, for me, pin down or grasp the real essence of why you're buying this piece of furniture. The thickness of the glass might not be quite right. You can see there's a really deep green tinge to this glass, which means the high lead content in there, which means it's a good quality of glass. The lamination of the timber underneath and the way it's been used and finished is particularly good. It's very simple, isn't it? But the way they finished it off is very beautiful. And if you're ever going to buy one, make sure what you're buying is an original and not a copy. A copy is worth nothing.
One of the problems with wooden furniture is it can be very large.
Little shop counter.
Oh, cutie.
Isn't that nice?
Yeah.
It takes up a lot of space in the van.
Oh, my God.
And a lot of maneuvering to get it in and out. A problem furniture stores like IKEA have eliminated.
love it or loathe it, flat pack furniture now is something we're all completely used to. But in the 1950s, this was revolutionary.
Clever design and problem solving were behind the success of a 1950s wooden classic from Denmark.
This is the France chair, designed by one of the giants of Scandinavian design, Finn Yule. Everything about this chair sums up the brilliance of Scandinavian design in this era. We're talking 50s and 60s. This was groundbreaking stuff in its day.
In an era of brilliant Danish designers, Finn Yule was at the forefront. In 1945, he created a sensation with his 45 chair. Called the mother of all modern chairs, the design's freedom from traditional forms was revolutionary. Americans in particular wanted more of his casual and cool designs. But there was a problem. His chairs were bulky.
If you go to buy this chair and you've got your estate car, maybe get two, maybe three in the back of it. People generally buy chairs in twos, fours, sixes and eights.
The problem of bulk was scaled up when it came to any kind of international sales.
I'll tell you, as an antique dealer, shipping furniture around the world is my biggest loss. It takes lots and lots of time to wrap them up. Potential damage, dealing with couriers, it's a bit of a nightmare. Finn Yule wanted to expand into new markets. Denmark is a very small country. They needed to get these into the world.
The solution to Finn Yule's problem came from an English engineer called Charles France, who was living and working in Denmark. France developed an idea to create wooden chairs that could be transported in pieces. And he addressed another sticky issue.
A lot of Scandinavian furniture was mostly made of teak. And when you use a saw like this, it just jams them up because they're really, really oily. France discovered that you could get these tungsten carbide saws, and that would just cut through it much more easily.
In the early 50s, Charles France and Finn Yule collaborated on a new teak wood chair. Yule designed it specifically to be machine cut and transported in flat-packed, easy-to-assemble pieces.
This is the impossibly chic chair that Finn Yule came up with, the FJ136. This was the first Danish design chair to be flat-packed. Flat-pack revolutionized everything. You didn't have to go and collect one in your car. Now you could order six, seven, eight, and put them in the boot. It just made life so much easier. And I'm sure at first it was a little bit of fun to put them together yourself. What it did for the makers of Scandinavian furniture, it allowed them to ship their goods around the world quickly and cheaply. And then it just went mad.
The FJ136, or France chair, as it was later dubbed, became a hit on the American market.
The choice of timber's fantastic. These almost sort of wings sloping down off the side here. The angle of the seat, the angle of the backrest, just the amount of upholstery they've put into it. It's perfection in Scandinavian design and perfection in the first flat pack.
By the end of the 50s, flat packed Danish furniture had gone truly global. At the same time, a small Swedish mail order company called IKEA began selling its own flat pack designs. Today, it's an international Goliath with stores in 27 countries. But you can follow its roots back to the genius of Englishman Charles France.
If you want to buy one of these things, it's quite nice because you can actually still go and buy one of these brand new, like this one, for about £2,500. An early original one is going to cost you double that, £5,000. These are a rare little beast, but a great investment, I think. Condition-wise, they need to be as near perfect as you can possibly get. The collectors of these things, the real connoisseurs, want them in almost mint condition. All the joints need to be good. You don't want to see any visible repairs. All of the pieces that mount it, so all of the screws, all of the fixings, all of those need to be original. On the early ones, there's a maker's mark as well. You want to make sure that is absolutely the right thing. And then it's just down to how many do you want? They're out there, and they're a great buy, and it's a chair that will last you a lifetime.